With the country still puzzled on who is behind the graying murders, the opposition is under panic that the killer's arm might stretch to some of its members. Addressing journalists in Kampala this morning, the Secretary General of Uganda Youth Democrats, Charles Waswa, observed that if they could brutally murder a brigger who even had security, what about the opposition leaders? He advised those on opposition to remain vigilant.
That if they can kill within government, then they can reach out within the opposition. I would like to make a call. As opposition, we are timid, threatened, and actually we are in a situation of despair. We have the resilience to move on, but likely worried that this terrorist arm that cannot be curtailed can actually stretch into the opposition, and this is a challenge.
Abiriga is best remembered for being among lawmakers who spearheaded the move to amend the country's constitution to remove Article 102B so as to have the 75-year presidential age limit removed. Waswa contends that Abiriga's death cannot be separated from the age limit saga.
We can't even lie to ourselves that the death can be any other thing away from the age limit debate. And it's not as if Ugandans do not know the cause of the death. Ugandans know. And the security apparatus know. Therefore, as Ugandan Young Democrats, we do not condone the murder. We do not condone the nature. Likewise, we condemn the selfishness of politicians and greed.
They advise government to draw quick measures of withdrawing the firearms in the hands of private people. The circumstances surrounding Abiriga's death resemble that of the country's former Assistant Inspector General of Police, Andrew Kawesi, now the lead, and his two bodyguards in Kampala last year. Kawesi and his guards were shot dead by assailants riding a motorbike in a killing that shocked the nation.